गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट वेल्डिंग टॉपिक आफ्टर प्रीवियस स्लाइड. सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस स्पेशल केसेस ऑफ फिलेट वेल्डिंग. सो थ्री स्पेशल केसेस वी कंसीडर टुडे. फर्स्ट आई हैव जॉट इट डाउन ऑल थ्री. सर्कुलर फिलेट वेल्ड सब्जेक्ट टू टॉर्सन. सर्कुलर फिलेट वेल्ड सब्जेक्ट टू बेंडिंग मोमेंट. फर्स्ट इज टॉर्सन, सेकेंड इज बेंडिंग मोमेंट, एंड थर्ड इज लॉन्ग फिलेट वेल्ड सब्जेक्ट टू टॉर्सन. जनरली फॉर इफ यू सी इफ इट इज अ टी एंड इट इज वेल्डेड हियर, दिस इज अ लॉन्ग फिलेट वेल्ड सब्जेक्ट टू टॉर्सन. दिस इज थ्री केस वी कंसिडर टूडे. एंड लास्ट वन इज दैट बट वेल्डिंग स्ट्रेंथ. सो दिस फोर टॉपिक वी विल कंसिडर टूडे. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट, that is circular fillet weld subject to torsion. So I have put this sketch. This is a plate, this is shaft. So it is welded in this plate all around. If we consider D is a diameter of rod, R is radius of rod, definitely R is equal to D by 2, T is equal to torque acting on rod, S that is size of weld we have discussed in previous, T is throat thickness and J is polar moment of inertia. So we will just derive how we get the formula. So we know that torsional equation T by J is equal to Fs upon R. So T is equal to torque, J is equal to polar moment of inertia, Fs equal to shear stress, because here shear stress will apply because it is rotating. So once it is rotating, definitely failure will be shear failure. Okay, so this is a shear stress and R is a minimum distance from the neutral axis, that is radius R. So if we write like Fs, what is the maximum shear stress? That is T into R upon J. It's, and if you write T into D by 2, that is R is equal to D, and what is J for a particular shaft, that is pi T D by 3 upon 4. What is J here? Polar moment of inertia of weld, okay, of weld, not a shaft. So if you see, this is a plate and this is a shaft and this is a welding. If I write in a green color, then this is a welding. So polar moment of the weld, so that is pi T D3 upon 4. So do you understand? Okay, so if I cut it, then what SFS will T into, this is 4, this is 2, so 2 will come upside, into D upon pi T D cube. So D will cancel and it is 2, and Fs is equal to T T upon pi T D square. So this is a formula for circular fillet weld subject to torsion. So whenever you will weld shaft with particular plate or whatever, wherever you want to weld, just you check the Fs. That should be 2 times of torque divided by 2TDQ. T is a throat thickness. If you want to change it on size of weld, because generally we are considering size of weld, then it is 2T upon pi into 0.707 S D square. Correct? If we divide by this one, then Fs will is equal to 2.83 T upon pi S D square. As per my opinion, you always consider this formula because it is easier to memorize. Fs is equal to TT upon pi T D square. And whenever you want to put S, just you multiply it by 0.707, that is sine 45 degree. Value of sine 45 degree. So we have seen first circular fillet weld subject to torsion, then this is next point, same condition but it is subject to bending movement. So same here, if you see, this is a welding joint all around, this is previous, it is what, torque, now this time a movement. So this time it is movement. Now same is a previous, D is equal to diameter of shaft, radius, size of weld. See, this is size of weld and this is throat of weld. Okay, Z section modulus of joint. So pi TD square upon 4 is a section modulus of welding joint here. Previously we have seen that this is a polar movement of inertia of welding joint, that was pi t dq upon 4, and this is pi t d square upon 4. So this is difference, this just I put down here. Okay, so previously we have seen that torsional equation for torque. Now we are discussing regarding bending movement, so we consider a bending equation that M upon I is equal to FB upon Y. You can say Y is a minimum distance from neutral axis to extreme end. So this Y is equal to R only because it is a shaft. So if I put a R here, so what will be the FB? That is M into R upon I. So R is equal to, if you put FB is equal to M into D by 2, correct? And I is equal to you see, we have considered Z. So YZ, if I put I here, and we know that Z, so we know Z is equal to I upon Y. So here it is R, so I upon R is equal to Z. So we can write here M upon Z. So M upon pi T D square upon 4. So I just rewrite it, 4 M upon pi T D square. This is a formula. Same, if we eliminate T and put a S, size of weld, then it will be FB into 4M upon pi 0.707 SD square, that is 5.66 m upon pi s d square. So this is a formula. So this is a main formula which we have to memorize, because it is easy. Fb is equal to 4 m pi t d square. This is for movement, bending movement. Okay, and we have seen that torsional moment, that is Fs is equal to 2m pi t d square. So just if you see the numerator and denominator, this is a denominator, both are same. Numerator, it is 4m, 4 into bending moment and 2t, this is t. 2t, so double Fs should be double of the torque divided by pi t d square, and here bending moment should be stress of that bending stress should be 4 times of bending moment upon pi t d square. So this is the formula which we have to take care of that during welding joint of the circular shaft. So this is a third case, you can say, long fillet weld subject to torsion. You have seen here, this is a plate, this is a plate number one, this is plate number 2, and this is welded here. Complete along the length. So you can weld it both side or one side. One side weld, one side stitch, or both side stitch, whatever as per your design. So what is subject to? Subject to torsion. So how the torsion will act on this? So if from here, correct, to be precise, if I want to make it, then it, if it is center, so this is a center and this is acting as a, this is torque acting on this. Okay, so according to the torque, we have to check the strength of the welding or how much stress it can be taken. Okay, so T is equal to torque acting on a vertical plate. Okay, this is a torque. We can write it T here. So L is the length of weld. This is complete length, weld length. Size of weld, that S is the size of weld. We have already seen that S and T. So always this is S, size of weld, and this is throat thickness. So the torque is acting, then spooler moment of inertia of weld. So this is TL3 divided by 12. If we are putting it both the side, then it will multiplied by 2. If it is one side, so definitely always better to weld both side, either a stitch or continuous weld. So maximum we are using 2 multiplied by TL3 divided by 12. Okay, so as we have seen first case where circular shaft welded on the plate, then we have seen the torque equation. So what was the torque equation? T by J is equal to Fs upon R. So same torque equation is here. T by J is equal to Fs upon R. So same here, if we put Fs is equal to T into R upon J, and R is equal to what is R here? R means maximum distance from the center. So this is L, maximum length, then R is equal to L by 2. So T into L by 2, and we have written J is equal to TL Q upon 12. Generally we are considering it both the side, so I will multiply it by 2 here. So if it is 6 and 6, sorry, it is cut by here, so 3, what will be the Fs? That is 3t capital T upon small t L Q. So this is a formula for long fillet weld subject to torsion. So we have seen three conditions. What was the first one? That is circular fillet weld subject to torsion. Second, circular fillet weld subject to bending. And third one is long fillet weld subject to torsion. So it is a subject to torsion. And if I write completely, then it is long fillet weld. So just see the comparison of all three formula. So long fillet weld subject to torsion, if I see the previous formula, I write here pi t d square, that is subject to circular fillet weld subject to torsion, correct. And last one, F B bending stress, that was 4 m pi t d square. What was this? This is circular fillet weld subject to bending moment. So this is subject to movement. Here it should not be cube, it should be square, because all are square. Okay, here we didn't cut it, this is 2, this is L. So Fs is equal to 3t upon 3 capital T torque, 3 torque upon T L square. This is subject to torsion long fillet weld. So all three formula I have seen. Now we go for strength of butt welding. So strength of butt welding, I have put this is a 2 plate, it is welded here, it is a butt welding, this is a butt welding, 2 plate is joining like this. Okay, so here if you see, this is a length of weld, this is a length of weld, or this is a throat weld. This is power acting or load acting on this plate. So definitely if it is pulled by both side, so here tensile stress will act. Okay, so what if tensile stress is working, then we will find tensile strength of the weld. So what will be the tensile strength? So tensile strength of butt weld hai ye, butt weld, butt joint, whatever you want to write. Okay, so here I have put single butt weld joint. Okay, single butt joint. So what I write? P load, you can say load. What will be the load carrying capacity of this welding joint? That's L into T. Simple, L into T, and what multiplied by stress? If it is tensile stress, then it is Ft. So strength of the weld is P is equal Lt Ft. And if you consider, it is a double weld, means this is a plate and this is a double butt joint. Then definitely length will be double. At that time, here you see this is a complete T, and now it is a T and this is T. Sometime it happens, its thickness is 4 mm, its thickness is 5 mm. So we can write T1 and T2 also. So if I put different thickness of both side of the plate, because what happened when plate is 50 mm thick for chimney, stack and all these, if we are welding, then plate thickness more than 40 mm, 50 mm. At that time we can weld it some different thickness in this side and some different thickness other side. So this is T1 and this is T2. So at that time what we write? P is equal to L into T1 plus T2, simple, and Ft. So this is a butt weld tensile strength. So we have seen fillet weld and butt weld welding strength. For next slide we will solve some numerical questions. Till then, goodbye.